Good morning, viewers. My name is Mr. Austin, and I'm here to guide you on understanding QuickBook menu bar. So this is our homepage for Saving Life Hospital. And here is our menu bar, file, edit, view, list, favorite, company, customer, vendors, employee, banking, reports, online service, windows, and help. So we'll start with file. Now file, this is the first is the new company. If you click on it, to take us back to the first screen that says Express Start Advanced Setup, which we use to open Saving Life Hospital. Close this, take us back, click on this. We ask us to input the password. Input the password. Okay, make this match. So we'll go back to file. The next one is open and restore company. Now, what it means is that when you have backed up a company and you want to restore it, you just go through this and open a company file, restore a backup company, and restore a portable file. You go through this, able to restore the data that you have backed up. Close this. We have open previous company. We have 5, 6, 7 numerous company file, and each one of them will be detailed there. So you can pick the ones that you have worked on recently or the ones you have worked on not much, not recent. Create backup. You want to backup your file. This here you click on to show my online bank backup or local backup. We have restore a previous local backup. When you have backed up locally, all the backup will be showed here. So you just pick the one that is of recent and the one that's not that recent. Create copy, close company. If you are through with your posting and want to close the company, just click on this. It tell you it's very important you need to back up to avoid any accidental data loss. Would you like to back up? Say yes. To take it to the backups section, click on this. We're not backing up. Let's close it. That's closed. So we'll just click on this to open it. Put the password. So we have switched to multi-user mode. Now this mode, it provides easy access for every user to have access to the company file. If we want to have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 20, 30, 40, 60, depends on the QuickBook model you are using. If you click on this, it will give access to every users after they have input their requirement, which shows that they must have input their password and their username. So from here, you will click on yes. It will take you to where the Windows administrator gives the permission. If you click on continue, it's taking you to another setup page. We'll look on that later in previous chapters. Watch this. We now have remote utilities. If you want to import from an Excel file, export, likewise, if you want to export from QuickBook to any other files, what to copy file for QuickBook Online. If you want to copy file to QuickBook Online from your desktop, okay. Accountant copy. We have save file, send to accountant, print form. What kind of form do you want to print? The invoice, paycheck, sales report. Then your printer setup is provided here. You have the edit, the use register, use calculator. If you want to complete one or two transaction, you can use a calculator. You'll find transaction. If you want to find any transaction, you can click on the likewise search. The preferences will be able to give you an option on how you want your account to be run. Accounts, bills, calendar, check-ins. In our next chapter, we're going to actually look at preferences. So let's close this. We have list, shows the chart of account, the item list, the fixed assets, new assets that you might acquire. You put everything under the fixed assets, item list, price list, list of all the prices that you want to. You have to do involve in every transaction that are provided here. Customers, vendors list, all the customers and your vendors, they provide this and provide here the type of customers you are involved, the type of vendors you are involved, and others. We have the free company homepage, company snapshots, calendar, document, lead center, company information, advanced service administration, setup, like I said, in the multiple user mode, when you have like 5, 6, 7, 20 to 30 usernames, is from here the user set up their username and their password. Closing dates, planning, if you want to set up a budget, forecast and cash flow projector to sell, you click on chart of accounts, which is where the chart of account is. Company. Let's close this first. Go back to company. You have your make journal entries from here. When you want to correct any transaction, to say you click on the journal will be raised. Customer center shows the names of all your customers. Create invoices. The invoices you create to the customers for them to make payment. You can purchase in badges. Enter all your sales receipts. Receive payment. Every payment that will be made by the customers. Here you impose every one of them. Credit refund. If you want to refund your customers. Vendors, we have the vendor center, same thing like the customer center, all the details of the vendors, enter bill, the bills that are raised by the vendors, here you enter one of them, and the pay bill, this is where you make the payment for every bill that they entered. Employee center, those are it shows the details of all the employees that's working under the company, that time, the timing, that's the time, the duration of their work. Everything is provided here. Banking shows the right check, the checks you write to pay to your clients. Other checks available, other new checks. Make deposit, every deposit that's made to the bank, we record everyone here. Every fund is transferred from every fund that you transfer within the bank, every should be recorded. Reconciliation at the end of the particular period, you can reconcile your transaction. And raising your ledger report and reconciling with the bank statement. From here, you click on loan manager. If the company collects loan from the bank, you click on the loan manager to take it to another setup where you're able to monitor the loan given. Reports. This report shows the company financial reports, customer receivables. Other company financial report shows the P&L, the balance sheet, income and expenses. As from here, you're able to know if the company is making a profit and loss, which is very vital for decision making in the managerial level. Customer receivable, likewise, this customers and receivables shows the balance the customer is going to the company, which can be done weekly, monthly, or daily. It's also vital for managers to know those customers that are owing the company in a long or short term period. You have the sales by customer, sales by customer details, all the services you render to the customer. You can see every one of them and generate a report for everyone, according to the customer and according to the item. Vendors, Likewise, shows the amount you are paying the vendors, shows the balance you are owing, shows the details, and shows those that are not billed, have not been paid. Go to banking, deposit details, reconciliation discrepancy, if your reconciliation and reconciliation did not balance and you want to adjust it to make it balance, it should generate a discrepancy which you are able to input here. The account and tax shows the track balance, general ledger, transaction detail, journal, audit trail. The budget forecast shows the budget and the actual. It's very useful when you want to create a budget and you want to do your forecast. Online services shows the services that's been rendered to each web, payments, network, mobile and online services, websites, managing services, windows, arrange icon. If you want to arrange your icon as your back icon, click on this. Help, if you're having difficulty in one or two transactions and you need the support from QuickBook, you can come through this particular menu, QuickBook Help, and you'll be able to assist you. So these are the menu bars, every one of them, and each of their sub are all useful while you are working on a particular company file. So in our next chapter, we'll be looking at preference. Like I said, this particular section will be able to help us arrange and also make some adjustments in our chart of account and others. So I hope to see you in the next chapter. Thank you very much.